Warathena Putha is good morning in the Kalkatunga language. My name is William Blackley. I'm an emerging elder for the Kalkatunga tribe and a traditional owner for the land on which we gather today. I'm here to help you all get your NAIDOC celebration underway, which celebrates the longest continued culture in the world, the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander culture. And that culture belongs to this country, Australia. So therefore, it belongs to all of us together to share. I'm originally from Palm Island, and I take my Kalkatunga heritage from my maternal grandmother. She was removed from this country and sent to Palm Island where she grew up. I'm also a cultural practitioner here in the community. I help our people reconnect to their culture through dance and language. And I also like to try and educate the wider community about, the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander traditional ways and the way we are and about our beliefs. So as a traditional owner, it is very important to preserve the old ways and to continue the practice of making people feel welcome and safe when they come to our country. So firstly, I'd like to offer a blessing from the old people in our language, and then a welcome, especially to anybody here today who hasn't been welcomed to country before. And the blessing itself asks for the answers to keep you all safe, make your spirit strong, and guide you in the right way when you are on country. So, Nariyi, Pumpamanat, Kulumatu, Jayanati, Putupia, Akira, Akonun, Puni, Talpuni, Tirma, Nariyi, Wakatari, Nienta. And so now I'll do the a welcome. Ngai Kalkatungu Kulianu Pumpariji Nyanglu Kalkatungu Ngai Muja Kalkatungu Jirama Ngato Yurumia Marpai Mia Jainati Putupia Nu Iti Marpai Tu Jamu Jirama Ngato Inchi Mia Mato Anchi Mia Kalkatungu Ja Kulianu Kalkatungu Ngai Jamu Jirama Airapia Mato Inchi Mia Kula Anchi Mia Australia Ja Ngai waira tingu, nini waira ana, puta nini, Kalkatunga muja. So that just says to everybody, I pay my respects to our old people, our ancestors who lived on country for thousands of years. Also pay respects to our modern day elders, both past and present, and the Kalkadoon Nation that is still connected to the country we live on today. And as a traditional owner, Kalkadoon man, I acknowledge the links to all people throughout this country, and I pay my respects to your elders as well. And that last bit is from my spirit, my heart to you all. I welcome you here to Kalkadoon country. Thank you.
Good morning and welcome to our liturgy to celebrate NAIDOC Week for 2021. We welcome our very special guest, Mr. Jack Wilson, Mr. Will Blackley, Father Mick Lowcock, Councillors George Fortune and Phil Barwick, parents, carers, staff and students. The theme for NAIDOC Week 2021 is Hill Country.
This year's theme is a simple one. It's really a call for us to protect country. So it's heal country. The committee really feels that it's a call for all of us to work towards greater protections of our land, our water, our sacred sites, and our culture and heritage. It's about healing country. It's about healing us as a peoples. And when we talk of country, we don't talk of land. We actually talk about country as a person. Country sustains who we are. We sing about country, we celebrate country, we dance about country. So it's really saying, heal country and we heal us as a people.
Mentioned in the video, the theme Heal Country is a call for all Australians to protect our lands, waters, sacred sites and cultural heritage for future generations. NAIDOC Week in 2021 is an opportunity to embrace the histories, knowledge and traditions of our First Nations peoples. It's about walking towards mutual respect for other cultures and values of Aboriginal people and Torres Strait Islanders as they do the cultures and values of all Australians. We all play a part in healing country when we acknowledge the past wrongs and work together towards reconciliation. Heal Country is not just about environmental recovery of land, it is about people, all of us eradicating racism, unjust practices, and systematic disadvantage. When we heal people, we heal the country. It is also about celebrating the oldest continuous living culture on the planet and taking opportunities, not just in NAIDOC Week, but in every week, to be open to the Spirit of God who has made his home in all of us, in all our cultural diversity. And in every encounter, every relationship, embrace everyone as family, as brother and sister, created in the image and the likeness of the Lord of heaven and earth. Today, as we listen to God's word and participate in our fun activities and games, let's reflect on where we are in our journey of reconciliation and unity and how we can work with others to heal the country. Please stand and join for our opening hymn.
This is our future, this is our home, a land of reaping, a land of harvest. This is our land, this is our home, this is the great south land of the Holy Spirit, a land of red dust and summer rains. To this sunburned land we will of blood, and to this great south land, this great cross. This is our nation, this is our land, this land of plenty, this land of hope, the richest harvest.
Morning, we begin our liturgy together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's just bow our heads and pray. Remembering the gift of life that each of us has. God of love, like the great rainbow serpent, Yirrawarra Kantara, you're the creator and hero of this land and of all good things. Our hope is in you because you gave your Son Jesus to reconcile the world to you. We pray with you for our strength and grace to forgive, accept and love one another as you love us. And forgive and accept us in the sacrifice of your Son. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. You might be seated.
Holy God, who loves, give birth to all people, to all creation. We ask you to give us your spirit of gladness and respect for everything. Lord, have mercy. Holy God, who became one of us, drawing all people into your life, we ask you to give us your spirit of tolerance and understanding of the wonderful variety of human beings and their cultures. Christ, have mercy. Holy God, who forgives us endlessly and always offers us new insights and new ways of thinking, we ask you to give us your spirit of humility and reconciliation to omit our times of intolerance and neglect of others. Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. But since you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, we have kindled in you. See that you also you also excel in the grace of giving. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you, through his poverty, might become rich. Our desire is not that others might be relieved while you are hard-pressed, but that there might be equality. At the present time, your plenty will supply what they need. The goal is equality, and it is written, "The one who gathered much did not have too much, and the one who gathered little did not have too little." The word of the Lord. Please stand to sing the gospel acclamation.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Bless you, Lord. Just then a lawyer stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he said, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "What's written in the law? What do you read there?" He answered, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." And Jesus said to him, "You've given the right answer. Do this and you'll live." But wanting to justify himself, he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" And Jesus replied, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho. He fell into the hands of robbers. They stripped him, beat him. They went away, leaving him half dead. Now by chance, a priest was going down the road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise, a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, an outsider, while travelling, came near him. When he saw him, he was moved with pity. He went to him and bandaged his wounds. He poured oil on them and wine on them. Then he put him on his own animal and brought him to an inn to take care of him. Next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper and said, 'Take care of him, and when I come back, I'll repay whatever you will spend.' Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers?" And he said, "The one who showed him mercy." And Jesus said, "Go and do likewise." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God of holy dreaming, great creative spirit, from the dawn of creation, you have given your children the good things of Mother Earth. You spoke, and the gum trees grew. In the vast deserts and dense forests, in the cities, at the water's edge, your creation sings your praise. Your presence endures as the rock of the heart of our land.
When Jesus hung on the tree, you heard the cries of all your people and became one with your wounded ones. the convicts, the hunted, and the dispossessed. The sunrise of your Son colored the earth anew and bathed it in glorious hope. In Jesus we have been reconciled to you, to each other, and to your whole creation.
Lead us on, Great Spirit, as we gather in this special place located in Kalkadoon land, and where the ancestors of long ago gathered for work, play, and praise. Enable us to work in trust from the hurt of the past into the full day which has dawned in Jesus Christ. Amen.
We all know that this little note has a little bit of value. If I said, do you want one? Does anyone want one? Of course, we'd put up a hand, we'd take it straight away, that right? We know it's worth $50. If I crunch it up, put it on the ground, even if I walked over it, walked away, you'd still pick it up because you think it's still worth $50. Each of us has a value too. Sometimes there are people in our lives that we walk over, trample down, or walk past, just as the example Jesus gave in that story. And they have as much value as each of us. Each of us is created in the image of God. Each of us has as much value as you want to place on yourself. Each of us has as much value as your parents, family, and our community place in you. So for each of us, we're called to value one another. Not just to say you're of value, but in your own heart, to value one another, and particularly those we sometimes say they're hopeless, they're a waste of space, they're no good. Whether we do that at school or whether we walk uptown and see some people, we might say a hopeless drunk. One of the biggest funerals I've done in Mount Isa was a fellow who died in a rubbish bin in Townsville because family saw in him real value. Each of us are of real value. And the real thing is we can see in $50 because we know what we might do with it. The real thing for each of us to say, how can we see that value in one another? And how can we encourage one another to have that value? Mini monkeys, feed the troops here. So if the packet, someone wants some? That's right, fight over it. That's what we're about, isn't it? But apart from fighting over it, now we've got an empty packet and it's not of much use, is it? So what do we do with the empty packet? We throw it away. When we walk around town, where we've been to Macca's or Hungry Jack's or Red Rooster or whatever, all the empty stuff, we just throw it away. We don't think much about it. But today's a day for us to think about, how do we heal country? How do we heal one another? How do we heal this land on which we stand, which is ours, gifted to us? Do we waste it, destroy it, or are we people who really cultivate it and make it for the best use that's possible? When Jesus used the example of the good people who walked past a person who was seen to be almost dead and said the outsider, the Samaritan, who doesn't even belong to that country, comes along and looks after him and pays for him to get better. He's inviting each of us to be a neighbour to all those people, the outsiders, those who seem to be of little value. By the way in which we live, we say we're for that, following Jesus, or we say we're just looking after ourselves. We don't care what we do. If you think the end of the world's coming soon, you can do what you like with the land. But some of us believe this land's here for a long, long time, and we want to care for it. We want it to grow. We want it to be something that's very special to us. Some of us believe perhaps we're going to leave school, never see these people again, so we don't worry about them. But some of us believe no matter where we go, we're of real value. No matter what we do, whether we go to university or work for the council on a garbage truck, we're of real value. All those jobs need to be done. We're of real value no matter what we do, because of who we are in our heart. Today's a day for us. This week of NAIDOC coming up is a week for us to treasure the country on which we stand, to make a stand to heal it, and the people that we stand with to heal and encourage one another. And so let us pray. Today we ask the Lord to be with us, to hear our prayers on this special NAIDOC occasion. This is the day to celebrate the gifts the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people bring to this country and to this college. We celebrate survival and the strength of culture and spirit.
We pray that Pope Francis and all church leaders with witness Christ, the Good Shepherd who laid down his life for his sheep, may they stand firm in teaching of Christ and stay and strong in proclaiming the gospel. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for compassionate local, national and global response to the needs of others in ways that reveal your love and mercy, especially to those who are suffering. We pray for the healing of all people troubled by poverty, dispossession and trauma. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for our elders and Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander community leaders who stand for us. May their minds and hearts be guided by their connections to community and to their family. Keep them safe from the burden of responsibility, and that they too may live in peace and harmony. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our sick and dying, the homeless and imprisoned, the refugees in detention, the weary and lost, that their faith stays strong and that the Blessed Mother Mary's love of all fills their hearts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for young people everywhere, and especially at Good Shepherd Catholic College. We pray that Mary MacKillop walks with them and touches their lives as they make their contribution to God and to the Church. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all people of the earth, that they will work together for peace and harmony in our troubled world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious and loving God, as we pray for the needs of your people, we ask you to help us to serve one another. And so welcome your beloved Son, who lives and reigns among us forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to stand as we sing the Our Father. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. As a sign of we value one another and of our commitment to mercy and love for one another, let's quietly turn to those around us and offer them a sign of peace. Let's ask for a blessing on our Indigenous brothers and sisters, for the First Nations people of Australia.
May the God of the dreaming bless them with strength and courage. Amen. Amen. May Jesus Christ be their gift of deep peace. Amen. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, Sacred Spirit, shine in their hearts with hope. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us and all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Island people in particular, along with Australians who share this great Southland. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so may the ancient dreaming inform and inspire us. The resilience and generosity of the First Peoples encourage us. The clarity and respect of the prophets motivate us. The endurance and colour of the land sustain us. The yearnings of all people for unity reconcile us. And may we hear the living God say, I'm here among you. Amen. Let's go in peace, glorifying the mercy of the Lord. Amen. Thanks be to God.
Gathering together to understand, to hear the whispers from this ancient land. Time people, sing us your song, tell us the stories of where you belong. The earth is our mother, this land is you and me. She holds us deep within her heart, now everyone can see. We're building one future for this nation, come together for reconciliation, living in the land of the Southern Cross. We are many melodies, making harmony. Lift your voice and sing your song with me, living in the land of the Southern Cross. Our plans have come from far and wide, from the rainbow serpent, mother of life. We're on a refugee boat or a jumbo plane, or a sailing ship in a prisoner's chains. She welcomes us with open arms and claims us as her own. We all belong together in this land that we call home. We're building one future for this nation. Come together for reconciliation, living in the land of the Southern Cross. We are many melodies, making harmony. Lift your voice and sing your song with me, living in the land of the Southern Cross. Sing this song to everyone. Winds of change have now begun, blowing clouds of pain away, bringing in a bright new day, where everyone is striving for justice in this land. We carry this dream within our hearts, together we can make a stand. We're building one future for this nation. Come together for reconciliation, living in the land of the Southern Cross. We are many melodies, making harmony. Lift your voice and sing your song with me, living in the land of the Southern Cross. Living in the land of the Southern Cross. Living in the land of the Southern Cross.
Thank you, everybody. Please sit down. Thank you, students, for your participation in that liturgy so respectfully this morning. So good morning, invited guests, parents, family, staff and students. As we heard during the liturgy, our theme for NAIDOC week this year is Heal Country. When it was first announced, I was very excited about the theme because I feel it's something that can resonate with all Australians. In Marcia Langton's 2018 book called Welcome to Country, Stan Grant talks about what country means to him. He says, "For years I have lived far from my country. I found new homes, New smells, sights and sounds slowly erased from my memory. But then I would fly home. I could feel Australia before I'd even seen it. I would often wake over the red centre, looking down on Earth like no other. Like a dot painting, it revealed itself, a mosaic of brush and spinifex and red dirt cut with creeks and red plains and hills. This country talks to me, he said. It talks in a language as old as humanity. This is a language that lives in art and music and story. If we open ourselves up, it will speak to us all. So for me, so we know that the word country is a term to mean traditional land estates inherited from ancestors as a matter of custom and according to the traditional land laws of each group of society. At Good Shepherd, we often hear the term used when someone makes an acknowledgement of country, a recognition of the traditional owners, the Kalkadoon people where we gather. But it's always a great privilege to hear a welcome to country, as we did today by Mr. Blakely. A customary welcome by a member of the local Indigenous community. On country, it is performed by Aboriginal groups to ensure the safe passage of visitors through their country. For Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders, being on country is more than just being physically present on the land. It is a sacred, spiritual and cultural connection to their dreaming and the old people who came before them. It is a place where rituals and ceremonies have been performed in this country for more than 60,000 years. Archaeologists have recently uncovered evidence that suggests that people have been living in the Arnhem Land in Northern Territory for over 65,000 years. But something else very significant happens when people gather on country. And I have experienced this in my life growing up in Townsville by spending much of my time in the bush near Charters Towers. I'm not an Aboriginal person, but I know the feeling of coming home and the deep bond of kinship within a family that cannot be broken. Kinship refers to how people relate to each other. And even if there is not a biological link, kinship relationships can be just as close and meaningful. In Aboriginal families, each person is born into a kinship network and it stretches back through the generations and the distant past, but also outward socially. The systems are complex and I don't pretend to fully understand them. However, I do know what it means to gather in a large family group around a campfire, sing songs and share stories about the past. There is nothing better for the soul than sitting with family and friends and sharing a meal and a memory. And this is what I think about when I hear the term heal country. To me, it is about taking a moment to appreciate the environment or the country where you are, to listen to the birds, the sounds of the bush, and spend time with people who you care about. And we know that everyone carries their own burdens and problems. But when we take time to sit with others, we can share those worries or perhaps forget about them for a little while. Opportunities for reunions and big family get-togethers are rare in our world today. And we can't just blame COVID for that. I think as a society, we need to bring back more of those traditions that bring families together. Whether it is camping trips, family picnics, or big celebrations such as weddings and christenings. Young people today, I believe, more than ever, need the supports of family and extended family, such as aunts, uncles, and grandparents. The age-old adage that you need a village to raise a child is no less relevant today. Heal Country is about respecting our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander cultures and traditions. It is about preserving our natural landscape so it can be enjoyed for future generations, and it is about resolving outstanding injustices, all of which will help to enhance our journey to reconciliation. Put simply, healing country is about gathering with family and friends and opening up ourselves to the experience of the land around us, opening up to someone about a problem, and taking time to really listen to someone who might be trying to tell us something. So this year, we are thrilled to be joined by Australia's most popular ninja warrior, Jack Wilson. Jack is a proud Kalkadoon man who grew up here in Mount Isa. Jack is going to share with us this morning his story and maybe reflect on what his what the theme of Hill Country means to him. So please, let's give a huge welcome to Jack Wilson.
G'day everyone. Good morning, good morning. My name is Jack Wilson. First of all, I just want to pay my respects to the Kalkadoon people, Kalkatunga nation here. I want to pay my respects to the elders, past, future and present. I want to acknowledge Uncle Will here, Brother Boy, for welcoming us officially. And I found it very heartfelt when he explained in depth about welcoming, and especially for people that may have never had a welcome before. So it's very strong. And being a Kalkatunga man myself, this is very healing for me to come back out on country and share my story, be back in the essence of this land, of our ancestors. My body feels like a goosebump right now because I've just got all these feels running through, and that's my spirit. That's my spirit vibrating, and that's my body letting me know that I'm where I'm meant to be. And I want to acknowledge every single one of you out there today, listening, our kids here at school and our teachers and our parents and our elders. And I want to acknowledge every single one of your spirits and souls, because you matter. Every single one of you are a miracle. Every single one of you are a genius. And every single one of you have a gift, okay? And life is full of precious moments, and life is full of pain as well. And we're going to endure that throughout our whole lives. And we got to remember that we are strong within, and it's all a learning curve, and we grow and heal from that every experience. So the main reason I come out today is, of course, for, Healing Country and NAIDOC. And I've been traveling around Australia for the last 3 or 4 years, sharing my story, sharing who Jack Wilson is, this man here, this kid. I feel like an everyday person. I still feel nervous up here. I feel that, everything that I've done, I've really pulled some heartstrings, and I caught the imagination of Australia on television, on Ninja Warrior, where you may have seen me, also known as the Deadly Ninja, that I was named. And, for those of you out there that hear the word deadly, deadly is a very strong word, a part of the Indigenous culture, and deadly means, cool, stylish, awesome. And, when you have that best friend or that brother or sister that you love so much and they're just deadly, like, that's what it is. And every single one of you are deadly. And we can all really have that name, We call each other deadly, and that's deadly, that's awesome. And we might even just do a little bit of a chant together on three, I am deadly. Hey, what do you reckon? Yeah, get that energy, just really, All right, one, two, three.
I am deadly.
It's the last day of school. It's, come on, you mob, hey? Better lift this roof off, split it down the middle, You should be excited. We need to get that energy up. So take a deep breath, or I'm going to go again. On your feet, there. Thank you, Father. Let's go, on the feet, stand up. I would say get on the chairs, but I know the safety, I'd be climbing up here if I could, don't worry. All right, just boom that chest up, boom chin up, and just scream it as loud as you can, because you got a heart that has a lot of spirit and power. Like, I'm feeling it already. I know you just want to just let go. All right, one, two, three.
I am deadly!
There, that's better. Give yourselves a clap. That's deadly. There you go. I can see some smiles now. People are all perked up. So that's what it's all about, We're all connected here. We're all interconnected. We may be all from different cultures, different backgrounds, different walks of life, different shapes, different sizes, different looks,
We're all very unique, and that's the most beautiful thing about this. And we all want love. Like, love is the cure, love is healing, and we're all here to share that love together, you know. I want you guys to really look at me as a brother or nephew, you know, for our elders, or, you know, uncle. Like, just call me Jackie, brother, Deadly, whatever you want to, you know. Like, I'm your friend. And that's what I want to really put out to all you kids today, especially, because I remember when I was at school watching someone come and talk, and, you know, they'd be talking about their life, and they'd be talking about that they learnt and all this sort of stuff, but I couldn't really connect with them people, because they, what it's all about is connecting to each other, you know. And you kids, you know, yous may be going through stuff at home, yous may be going through, you know, a bit of your own struggles of insecurity, or you may be going through family issues, domestic violence at home, yous may not have parents around. And I'm very aware of these things, because I'm very privileged, and I was fortunate to have a family, you know, a mother and father that give me you know, a good life at home. And we got to remember that, take that into account, you know. And some of our parents are struggling too, so maybe you can be that gift for your parents that are going through a hard time, and say, hey, look, mum and dad, like, I love you guys, you can get through this. You know, because we're all going to go through some struggles in life. But just remember, you can achieve whatever you want to achieve, whatever your gift is, whatever you love to do every day of your life, whether it's sports or art or music, you know, or you want to be a comedian, or you want to be an actor, you want to be an athlete, you know, you want to get a degree, whatever. If you can see it and believe it in your mind, you can do that. So every night before you go to bed, you write it down in your journal, and every morning you write it down. You can even repeat it in your mind. Does anyone know about mantras or affirmations? I sit up in the morning, and I make sure I do my affirmations, and I stand there and I say, I am deadly. I am amazing. I am loved. I am strong. You know, because these things, when you repeat them, that's not just you saying it, you're sending energy down into your body, and because you're so connected to this universe, to this land, the land hears you and will give you that gift. And that's why it's so important, because a lot of people make themselves sick these days. They're thinking in their mind all the time, I'm ugly, oh, they don't care about me, oh, what do they think about me, oh, I'm too, my color of my skin's not right, you know, I'm a little bit fat, or I look ugly, you know. That's not true. That's only from other people that have said that. From other people, bullies, even family members can put each other down. And I was put down as a kid too. I was a little fat fella. You know, I used to be called mole face. I had moles on my face. And, you know, I used to have little chubby titties. And my brothers used to give me a hard time. Good ways. That's just the truth. And I must say, you know, they shaped me as a person to grow up, because now I got thick skin, and I thought to myself, well, you know what, I'm just going to get fit and strong now, and then what are they going to say? And now who's laughing? You know, I'm looking after them fellas now. Nah, Gavin, they're still my older brothers, but they're looking up to me now, you know, they're looking up to me, and I used that pain and that suffering of hurt, you know, when someone calls you a name or something, you feel real down, you feel like you're not worthy. You feel like you're a disaster, but that's not right. You know, you find your tribe, you know, your vibe attracts your tribe. You know them good people. You kids in the room, look at your best friend or your little group, and you know who your number ones are, you know. You know who your brothers and sisters are, you know. You can really rely on them day ones. Your ride or die, as they call them, you know. So you stick to them people, and you create a strong little a little tribe, and that's what it's all about, the good energy and the good vibes. And I mean, yeah, that's what it's all about, healing, you know, love and being a good person. You know, Father was talking about this stuff here, you know, the money and all that, and we have that value too, you know. I'd probably be throwing fruit out there, not them little choc chips though. No, Gavin. No, good way, you know. And yeah, and like, you know, KFC and Macca's and all that, we don't even want to be eating that anyway. good ways. That's gammon. I used to love that stuff too, but I must say a lot of my healing has been from through healthy eating, eating off the land, fruit and vegetables. I know, you know, when mum and dad, that cooker, they might cook it boring, like steam it or something, but you got to get creative with these things. Put the herbs and the spices in there, you know, and really learn how to cook, because eating a good food will... So your gut is your second brain. Your gut isn't just a gut and then you do gunas. You take that nutrients and it becomes your body. Your food becomes you. So every 30 days, your body reproduces and expels all of its old cells and reproduces all the new cells through the food you eat. And sometimes with the food that you eat, if it has no nutrition in it and it's got processes in it, chemicals, these processes and chemicals go through your brain, and that's why you start thinking silly. You know, you might be thinking like, hey, you're like feeling angry at school or something, or you want to throw a chair or you want to throw your book or something. That's only because you've probably been eating slush puppies and McDonald's. You got to eat that deadly food that grew out of the ground, you know. That's got a journey too, that food. So that's what I'm all about, eating well and, like, you know, play up every now and then. You can have have a cheat meal or a little nice meal, but you really want to be eating the fruits that the land grew. And that's what I'm all about. And, you know, I'll talk a little bit about Ninja Warrior. I won't go for too much longer, guys, because I can speak all day. But Ninja Warrior has been such a beautiful experience for me because it's given me a voice. And I didn't even talk about where I was from. I've got that caught up there. I might just quickly track back to that because that's important. So I'm a Kalkadoon man, as I said, on my father's side. Also have ties down to Julia Creek and Hughenden, Nagwan and Yirrindali. So I'm still trying to figure out where my bloodline is. And Kalkadoon from here. And my mother is Welsh. You know, you might be thinking, this fella's not black fella, he's white. But I got white mum and black father. And that's a whole part of this healing too, is coming together. And I really feel like I'm blessed to have both sides, because now I can, because I dealt with a lot of racism. I dealt with a lot of confusion of my identity, of who I am. You know, when growing up as a young fella, like, black mob used to call me white and the white mob used to call me black fella. And I used to go home and I used to feel upset and I didn't know who I was, you know. And now I know who I am. And I went on Ninja Warrior with the Deadly Ninja Speedos, the flags, the Aboriginal flag with the white ochre. You know, that was shame. You know, anything could have happened there. They could have got caught on the obstacle and could have been hanging up there, you know. But I've done that to represent where I'm from. And I want to represent for other mob out there that have two diverse cultures to really appreciate where they come from. So my mother's Welsh. She's from Wales over there. She's first generation here in Australia, and my grandmother's from Northern Wales, and I have a little bit of English on my father's side, but I really feel like we're one, you know, we all one, we all live on this land. Uncle Will said earlier, you know, you're born in Australia, this is your land too, this is your culture. Unfortunately, some things have played out the wrong way, and some of our people are living, you know, in hardship and struggle, but they only just need love too, eh, you know. They're people just like us, so they just need that guidance and a little bit of help and love. So that's what we're healing now, and we're coming into the new age. So the new age is you kids. You know, that's why I'm very passionate about this and you children, because I want to share my knowledge with yous, and I want yous to all come through and guide and do what yous love, whatever your passion is. You know what I mean? So you might have seen me on Ninja Warrior, on the ads. I'm actually making a return this year. This is my fourth season. I had a really, really crazy accident last year. I jumped off a cliff in Bali and I broke my back. So I was in a foreign country. I jumped off this cliff because I love to do like extreme stuff because I want to push my body and risk my life. And I think I just love life so much. Like, I just want to become the best person I can. I skydive. You know, I run up mountains and do rock climbing, and jumping off cliffs is one of them. And I just didn't land correctly this time. I just a little bit out of my technique, and it was a bit higher than usual, and I found myself in the water with a broken back, and everything, my whole world was like very dark at that time. I didn't know what was going to happen. I had to climb out of the water. I had to ride a scooter to the hospital over there, and found myself in a foreign country with all these, you know, Indonesian mob speaking their lingo, and I was scared, and I told myself that I was going to be right. I said, I'm right, I can heal. I can heal my old people with me. I've got the strength within my heart, and I'm very lucky to have that mindset. I didn't go for surgery. I had no surgery. I healed myself naturally through all natural holistic practices, through healthy eating, plant-based eating. I've been vegan for 4 years. I've been doing a lot of breath work, so breathing techniques for healing, detoxifying the body and purifying. And I did a lot of yoga, so I do a bit of yoga now. So yeah, yoga has really been a savior for me as well, of realigning my spine and getting that getting that mobility and flexibility back, just moving the body and connecting to the body. Because sometimes in life we get caught up in the mind, but we got to realize like we got a heart there, and a lot of things can make us feel overwhelmed, and you just got to remember that you're strong. And I went through a big year of healing, and I didn't talk to anyone, and I was in a bit of a depressed state, you know. And I knew that it was my path to come back this year and show you guys, you know, how to come back from being knocked down. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm gonna put on a good show out there for you guys. So Monday night, tune in, and see how the Deadly Ninja goes, eh? But I really appreciate you having me up here today. I got a little project I've been working on, and it's very daunting for me. I want to share a little bit of it today, just quickly. I got an alter ego, so I do a little bit of character acting and playing, and I realize like a lot of this time that I've spent, I'm not just Jack Wilson, you know, like we're all who we are, but we're also very diverse people. And, you know, we love to be silly and have a good time and have a laugh. And I just love laughing. Like, laughing is like the best medicine for me and my family and my friends. So I've realized I've got a little TV show coming out soon. And I haven't actually shared this in public yet, so I'll show you a little bit of a snippet today. And it's called Jack's Family. So Jack's got this family that have, there's old man Jack, there's grandma Jacqueline, got father Jacko, and we got sister Jackie, and then we got me, Jack. All right, so I'm the son, and I got sister there, and I got some old people, and I've come into their life, and I've helped them out a lot, you know, and I'll share a little bit of what they have to say today. So I'll just introduce old man Jack here, because out of respect, you know, you got to introduce your old people.
Hey, which way you mob? Old man Jack here, and it's just very deadly to see yous all coming through today, and you young kids coming to school, and we didn't have this back in my day. And when I was growing up, you know, I was a hardhead, and I went off the rails, and, you know, I made some bad decisions, and now I'm paying for it playing football. And I didn't treat my body too well. I was drinking a lot, you know, and not keeping my health in check. And what my young man Jack taught me was, you know, to make sure that I care about me too, because I've always grown up being a hard man, and I have emotions too. So I'm going to focus on loving my family and teaching and learning about this healthy eating.
So that's the old man Jack there, you mob. I love him to bits. And I'll just introduce Grandma Jacqueline here now.
Yeah, g'day, love. My name's old Grandma Jacqueline, and yous are just so precious, you mob. Yous are so beautiful, and I just love being here today, and I just love my grandson Jack, and he's taught me so much. And what I want to really say about him is he's kept our family strong on this Deadly Ninja Turtle stuff. And what he's going to teach me is all that yoga and breathing, you know, because my bones are all frail, and I'm deteriorating, but he told me about breathing, and now I start to walk without my walking stick, and I'm out in nature and enjoying life again. Thanks, son.
So that's Grandma Jacqueline there. I'll leave it at that, and you can tune in. So if you want to watch that that series and that show, just tune into my social media in the future, and you'll see it all unfold, and you'll have a good laugh. So thank you very much for having me today. I've done the Ninja Warrior course for the kids later, so you kids come and bring your A-game. Have fun today. It's your last day of term, and let's have a good laugh, eh? All right, then. Thank you.
Can't wait to meet the rest of the family, Jack. So can we give Jack a big round of applause? That was awesome. So we just have a couple of last minute things to do, and they're very important. So there's a lot of work gone into your day today and how it's all going to unfold for you and for our liturgy this morning. So can we please in advance thank Miss Frew, Miss Jones, Miss Armstrong, Miss Webb, Miss Morganson, and the Indigenous Steering Committee for everything they've done preparing for today. Thank you for all our guests who have joined us. It was wonderful. We have St. Kieran's and St. Joseph's with us today, so you're very welcome at Good Shepherd. We do have three staff leaving us today, so if I could just ask Mr. Harrop, Ms. Spano and Mr. Jackson to please come and join us out the front. Okay. Now we have already, as a staff, done a farewell for Mr. Harrop and Ms. Spano. We are going to miss them both very much. Mr. Harrop has been with us for over 10 years, a real part of the furniture here at Good Shepherd, so he's going to be very missed by not just us, but many students who have come before the people who are here today over that 10 years. Ms. Barno has been with us for 2 years and has made a wonderful contribution to our English department, so you will be very missed as well. Mr. Jackson. Mr. Jackson has been with us doing a wonderful job as a school officer in the classroom, but particularly his contribution to the design and technology department. We're excited for Mr. Jackson. He's going into a permission to teach position at Spinifex, and I know that you're going to do an amazing job, but you'll always have a home at Good Shepherd. So can we please farewell our staff? Okay, I'm going to hand over to Ms. Morganson, who's going to tell us about our first rotation, which we're all very much looking forward to.
Yes. Alrighty, good morning, everyone. Oh, here he is. Thank you very much, Mr. Harrop. I'd also like to acknowledge today that our mayor, Danielle Slade's also here today, so I thank you very much for coming this morning. For us to start off with our rotations, so I'd like to ask, if possible, if our special guests could make their way to our library. We have morning tea on for our special guests there, so if I could ask you to make your way there, and I can then let the students know where we're at. So. Thank you. exciting. So everyone, if I could get staff and students to be listening, please, because we're running a little over time at the moment. Alrighty. So our first rotation goes from 9:50 until 10:30. So as you can see, we're already running a bit late. Benjamin, you'll be doing the Ninja Warrior course. So what'll happen is that when everybody else has left, what you will need to do is pack up and put all the chairs to the side, and then Jack along will ask some of you to assist him in getting everything set up. I know that your time is cut short, but we may be able to do something during lunchtime for you to be able to also fill in some time there. Bryce, you'll be doing the hand art activity, which will be in D5 and D6. So if you're in Rice House, can you please make your way there now? Thank you. McKillop, you are doing Move It Mob Style with Jacob up in the drama room, so if you can make your way to the drama room, please. And Chisholm, you will be cooking Johnny Cakes and you will be outside on the side of the LCC, thanks. All right. Hey, just leave them there, Doug. All right, Benjamin, let's pack up all the chairs. Remember, stacks of 12 on the side. The sooner we do that, the sooner we can start getting into it.